Welcome everyone to another episode of AppSec 101. We're happy to be joined today by Stan Wisseman, who is the Chief Security Strategist here at Micro Focus Fortify. And Stan has served as the Chief Information Security Officer for Fannie Mae prior to joining us. He was there up until 2014. And with regards to AppSec, Stan actually started the Nova OWASP chapter. He co-chaired a committee for the DHS Build Security in Initiative, and he also helped start the application security program at Fannie Mae. And Stan, is there anything else you'd like to add? Anything I left out of your background there?
It's good to be here, Andrew. And 30 years, I'm sure there are things you left out, but that's okay.
Well, we're happy to have you here.
That's good to be here.
Well, today we're going to be talking about API security and kind of what it is, some of the basics. And maybe let's start off by giving people a quick overview. What is API security?
Yeah, let's just start with the basics of, you know, what is an application programming interface, right? Applications or application components can leverage APIs, application programming interfaces, to connect to other apps and communicate autonomously. APIs are found and used by customer-facing, partner-facing, internal applications, and they support mobile, SaaS, and web apps. So, like any web request, API calls incorporate URIs, methods, headers, and other parameters. So that's a good baseline as far as first understanding what an API is. As to why they're important for modern applications, I mean, APIs aren't new. I was working with APIs when I was at Oracle back in the early 90s. We were porting our relational database system to different operating systems, and they had an operating system dependent layer, and I was working on a trusted version of Oracle and porting it to trusted platforms. And so, we've been working with APIs for years. But in the last few years, the architecture of applications has significantly changed. In traditional web applications, data processing is done on the server side, and the resulting web page is then sent to a client's browser for rendering. And as client devices have become more, varied and powerful, modern API-based applications use APIs to send and receive data from the backend servers to provide the functions to the application. And you may remember, back in the day, in the early days of smartphones, we were, using our banking apps and our favorite travel site on our smart devices. And we'd simply, basically be opening a browser on our phone.
Right.
And that is fine for a desktop computer, but it doesn't work really well on a mobile device. And organizations started realizing they can do things differently. So you had the folks that, did the financial apps and the travel apps and the retail apps start creating applications that used APIs more to be able to send in real time, the check balances, the money transfers, the seating availability, and not having to use a browser anymore. And that's, great for us as far as performance on our mobile devices. But there are also security implications of this, because more and more of that functionality has shifted from the more secure backend to processing on the mobile device itself. And so, that's something that we've seen, and we have to just deal with the fact that, the APIs are being leveraged this way. And we're seeing that in serverless architectures and microservices, single page applications, is very prevalent. And so that's why getting a handle on how APIs are exposed and how they're being used is important.
So as you talk about APIs becoming more prevalent, maybe let's dive into some of the risks that APIs pose today.
Yeah, so APIs define a backdoor to adjacent systems and apps for those who are intent on gaining access, both legitimately and otherwise. Detailed documentation is usually available for APIs to provide transparency to the developers. They need to know how the APIs work And they, you know, and that documentation helps. But that documentation also provides a blueprint for hackers to utilize APIs in their attacks. So again, APIs expose application logic and data, and therefore providing access to multiple sources of potentially sensitive data and mission critical services, that's a risk to you and your organization. And so that in turn can greatly increase your attack surface for your applications.
So when you have a wider attack surface, obviously that creates more avenues for hackers and creates, you know, more risk. So maybe let's touch on why it's so important to have clear visibility into these API attack surfaces.
Yeah, so I found, unfortunately, the reality is most organizations have limited or no awareness as to the APIs their applications are exposing, much less have controlled security controls over those APIs. That's changing. You're starting to see greater awareness there, but in general, that's the case. And as APIs are increasingly important and are hidden from view, they do present a bigger risk to the business. In fact, you know, we do an annual research report, you know, the Fortify team does, and they found back in 2008, based on the data they looked at for the report in 2019, that 35% of analyzed web applications had API abuse issues. And that increased to 52% for mobile applications. So understanding API vulnerabilities and weaknesses will help you gain a more comprehensive view of the potential attack vectors that could be used to breach an application.
Wow. So Stan, maybe you could touch on, for those that do have proper API security in place, what are some of these risks that can be mitigated?
Yeah, I mean, so if you think about some of the standard web attacks that we see, whether it be like injection or credential brute force, parameter tampering, session snooping, those all work well against APIs, just like they do against web apps. However, there's sufficient nuance and differences that OWASP, the Open Web Application Security Project, actually had a project launched a couple of years back focused on API security, which resulted in them producing the API security top 10 list last year, back in 2019. And this list, you know, rounds out the most critical API risks while also providing example attack scenarios and recommendations on how to mitigate those threats. And you know, it's not all encompassing. There's certainly other risks that aren't on that top 10 list, but it does give cybersecurity professionals as well as developers a better, you know, better insight as to what they need to do to potentially understand the risks that APIs pose, as well as how to mitigate them. So I really recommend that folks check out this API top 10 security list from OWASP.
Well, I'd like to talk about some specific solutions that users should look for to ensure proper API security. Do you have any recommendations on things that users should look to for mitigating risk?
Well, the first is just getting the visibility, right? You need to have the increased visibility into what APIs exist, who own them, which ports are they listening to. And unlike web applications that you can crawl, APIs have nothing to crawl. So it can be a little bit difficult to discover the APIs. So you see tools like Google's APIG, I always mispronounce that, and API collaboration software like Swagger Hub and Postman that can provide that fuller picture of an API and its interactions. So I really recommend that you leverage some of these tools to get that visibility. And then, you know, the other thing you can do with that information, you know, with the use of the output of these API collaboration tools, you can then provide that as input into vulnerability scanners like WebInspect. And that helps with the vulnerability analysis of APIs. And so scanning APIs with WebInspect will identify weaknesses and vulnerabilities, giving you the visibility you need into the risks specifically for those APIs that are exposed in your organization, and then you can take action to remediate them. Another consideration is, you know, how you cope with authenticated APIs. That can be quite complex in modern applications. I mean, you want authentication to be used. I mean, again, zero trust is something we encourage, and you want to have, where appropriate, authentication and authorization implemented. But when you're trying to scan an application, that can really halt the scan and prevent you from really being able to understand what the vulnerabilities may exist with that API. But a WeaponSpec actually is able to cope with these kind of complicated authentication and custom parameter requirements, and it can give you the coverage you need for your API scans. And finally, another thing that you're starting to see, an additional control, is using what we call API security gateways, like the NetIQ Security API Manager. And what these controls do is sort of serve as a governance layer to help you manage and secure and measure the APIs in use in your organization. So, you know, it's a combination of getting the visibility into what is actually being exposed, right? Then what risks are there, and then how are you governing your APIs in general? I think that combination is where people need to be going.
Just to wrap up, Stan, maybe we could talk a little bit about where you see API security going in the future. In your experience, what trends are you seeing? Are organizations getting better with API security? Are things trending in the wrong direction? What have you seen in your experience?
Right. So again, I still see that there's a lack of awareness. A lot of organizations are still dealing with the basics of trying to get an application security program rolling. But others that are more cutting edge do have projects underway to try to address the API security. And I think they're looking at that layered approach. First, like anything, you need to know what you got. And then you need to understand what those risks are for those applications that have exposed APIs. And then, you know, long term, how do you put in a governance control? And so, you know, again, a layered approach does make sense. I think that the very first thing they need to do is recognize that the attackers are leveraging these APIs and using them as a attack vector into your organization. So doing this as quickly as you can will help hopefully mitigate potential future attacks.
Yeah, that's great. Well, Stan, I appreciate you taking some time to talk with us today about API security. And hopefully our viewers can watch this and learn something and apply it to their organizations.
All right. And I think we're also going to include links at the bottom that'll get you access to the report that I mentioned, as well as the OWASP top 10 for API security. And I think there's going to be another link in there for Postman, in case you're curious about that as well.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, Andrew.
That's great. Thanks, Stan. We'll talk to you later.